met her when I was 17 and she was 18, just 6 months older, but she was always so protective of me. We both landed jobs, Rochester's elite department store, Tijuana Company. Our passion for fashion and friendship developed quickly into a sister bond. We called each other Beanie, a silly nickname. Going on to work together at a local bank, we experienced many milestones over the years, getting our first cars, going on our first trip, and being two young Italian girls with controlling parents, that was a big deal. And then getting our first apartment, that was another big deal. But needless to say, we got into a lot of trouble. A few weeks I got to spend with Barbara before she passed, we were able to reminisce about all the fun times we had, and I'm so thankful for that. But I want you to know, her legacy started in Rochester. I started a family, and she was making a name for herself. I was so proud of everything that she accomplished, as she was with me. She never letting me feel I was just a stay-at-home mom. She hired me many times to help her out in whatever she was involved in. She believed in me. I watched her mentor young girls and encourage them, making them feel confident in whatever they were doing. They looked up to her and they loved her. Her legacy will not only continue to dress for success and in this community, but to all the women she encouraged throughout her life. Her infectious laugh, her passion, and her love for her family, friends, and her job will never be forgotten. Cherish our friendship and always miss you. Thank you so much.
How do I follow that? First of all, I did have notes. We had a nice presentation I'm going to make. I did that the other day. And she's going to be on TV at 7 a.m. I had to wake her up.
She's really eager.
No credit to wake up. And I also was amazed that it almost looked like one of her sayings when I walked in here. And it's helping people. I love helping people. And I have a confession. I thought, until this occasion, I thought I taught her how to help people. And I finally discovered that she taught me all about helping people. She was so special, and she did help a lot of people, and the words have all been said, the emails all went through, people came from all over in joy. It was so special of you to come here, relatives who came all the way from FOMA. And I just wanna thank you all, and I just don't believe today and what was said, and I know I'm gonna try to continue to help people that need help, because everybody needs some kind of help, and we can all pass it on. This is all gonna be worthwhile. Thank you, and I guess I do love you all, even the guys, in a manly way.
It's been their honor. So I think Mal really summed it up. We have to continue to live Barbara's legacy. We have to continue to do good, and in that way, she will go on forever. So let's remember and celebrate not Barbara today, but every day. So find Barbara-isms in your life, put them on the calendar, jot it down, take a moment to reflect. We can carry on the legacy by giving of our time, talent, and treasure to another woman, because as women know, we're our own worst critics. And we need another woman, a strong woman, to stand beside us, take our hand, and help us on this journey called life. Barbara is immortal because of all she did. She's smiling down on us today, and her legacy will live on because she truly did the greatest thing any human can ever do. She made a difference. A big one. A really one. So we don't want the celebration to end. Feel free to eat, drink, mix, mingle, share stories. Again, there is a basket. They asked to move the flowers for any donations to go to Dress for Success so that we can keep Barbara's legacy very strong in the capable hands of the board and Nicole and her leadership. And thank you. Thank you everyone for taking your time out today to be here. So,